Hi friends, so today we will see the major features of C++ 14. Okay, so the major features includes like generic lambda, binary literals, digital separators, return type deduction and deprecated attributes. Okay, so we will go step by steps. What is generic lambda? Okay, generic lambda is nothing but you can use the auto as a parameter in that generic lambda function. Okay, so if you will use any of the parameter as auto, right, your lambda function will be known as generic lambda function. Okay, now what is binary literals? Okay, so when you initialize any integer variable, right, what you will write in that is like 0 1 2 3 4 5 or any other integer variable, right? But as a developer, you have the requirement to initialize your integer variable with 0 and 1, or we can say in the binary format, right? Then in that case you will need this feature of binary literals. Okay, so with the binary literals you can initialize your integer variable with 0 and 1. Okay, now what is digit separators, right? So digit separator is nothing but if you want to separate out your digits of integer while you are initializing it, so it will be easy for a developer to understand it, right? So this will provide this feature. Okay, well, now what is return type deduction? In return type deduction, right, you can use the auto as a auto as a return type, right? Like when you write any function, right, we will write the return type as integer, string or float or any other thing, but with C++ 14 you can also use auto as return type. Okay, so that is return type deduction. Now what is deprecated attributes? Okay, now as a developer you want your compiler to show the warning message while you compile your code. Okay, so with this deprecated attributes, right, you can show the warning message while compiling your code. Okay, now we will see each of the examples, this generic lambdas and all. Okay, we will write a small code for that. First of all, we will write generic lambda function. Okay, so we are writing auto as a return type. Also, we will write auto as a parameter also, right? Out all these values also. Okay, now we want our return type to be also auto, right? So we will declare an auto variable. In that we will what should we add? We will add string nature. We will write return in that. Okay, now we will return it. Okay, now we will see the example of binary literals, right? As I told, it is a integer only, but in the binary format, right? So we will start with 0 and b. Okay, always remember this is 0 and b. After that you will write the digit 1 1 1. Okay, this is nothing but 15. Okay, now we will see example of digital separators. Okay, digital separators, how it work is like, see, if we want to write 1, sorry, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, okay. So it will be easy to understand, okay. It will not do any improvement or speed of your compilation process. It will be just easy to read this number now, right? So this is the digital separator. Okay, now we will see return type deduction also. As we are passing the auto as return type from this generic lambda function, we will also take it as a return type, right? How it will be like fun, we will call this let's pass some string also and this b. Okay, we are calling that now deprecated attribute, like this is nothing but we want our compiler to show some warning message deprecated. Now here you will write the warning message also using CPP 14 features. Okay, this is our warning message. Also we will see out the return type of generic lambda. Okay, I will add comment also so we can rewrite the code. This is deprecated attributes. This is digital separator, right? Sorry, digit separator. This is code is ready. We will go for compilation of our code. Okay, see, if you see right, this is the warning message given by compiler, right? Now we will see the output also. See, this is the output 15 hello and 100000. Okay, and here the string also. Now if you open the code and we will make some changes here, okay. We don't want this warning, okay. Now we don't want this warning message. We will add one zero here, and now we want some another digit here, like 0001. That is one, right? Now, what we can do is, we don't want to pass the string here. We want to pass some integer value. We want to pass. Okay. So we have changed the code. We will compile the code. See, now you don't have any warning message, right? See, now the output is also changed. Again, we will make some modifications. Okay. Now instead of this integer, we will pass float values. Okay, in here binary literals won't work, right? 10.80, sorry. And here we will pass one string. Compile the code. a string library. See, now it is of float type, this is of string, and this is also of string, and here is the return type. Still we will do some experiment on the return type, right, as it is auto. Now we will pass string here. String we already saw, right? Yeah, it is working. Yeah, okay. So this all are the major functions or the features of C++ 14. Hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you all. Have a nice day.